A school wrestling coach is in serious condition after a collision with two semi-trucks. Coach Jeff Branch and his family were returning from a wrestling competition when he fell asleep at the wheel. His survival could be credited to his son and Gatorade. WLKY's Ann Bowden has more from Fern Creek High School.
Well, I'm standing in the wrestling room here at Fern Creek High School, the wrestling room that was the dream of Jeff Branch, and he helped build it. He has been coaching here for 13 years, but a horrific accident over the weekend almost took all of that away.
This photo of assistant wrestling coach Jeff Branch and his two sons was taken just hours before their Ford Edge collided with two semis. Head coach Mark Hitchings says Branch admitted he fell asleep.
When you look at the pictures of the vehicle that he was in, your first thought is, how does anyone live through that?
Branch spent days hand-making each trophy for the state middle school championships in Mount Sterling. He made the two-hour trip, then he left at midnight.
He was on his way home at midnight, and I think it all caught up to him.
As he fell asleep, Franklin County sheriffs say Branch's car rear-ended the back end of a semi, hurling his car across the median into an oncoming semi. The impact knocked that semi's axle from its base and caught the car on fire. Branch's wife was traveling behind the car and witnessed it all. When she couldn't open the doors or douse the flames with snow, she used Gatorade, and it worked. Branch had to be cut out of the vehicle and flown to UK Medical Center. His two sons only had scrapes and bruises.
As Coach Branch recovers, other coaches here believe that his recovery, his time in the hospital, will inspire his kids and also prove one of their mottos: you gotta wanna. If you can survive it, you can do it. Here at Fern Creek High School, Ann Bowden, WLKY News.
His family says Branch's youngest son held on to his father right before impact. He was not wearing a seatbelt. Branch suffered severe crushing injuries to his left side, but he's expected to make a full recovery. There are no cable barriers at that section of I-64 near Frankfort.